in their continuity offense, and 11 new players for the Los Angeles Lakers. LeBron James, year 19. I mean, for him to be 37 years old, turning 37 in December, to have the points he did last night, I might have to recalibrate my MVP conversation because I think he will be in that conversation. But look, you know, Carmelo Anthony at times, a defensive liability on the floor for them down the stretch in the fourth. It's going to take time for this team to find out what their identity is defensively and offensively. And Russell Westbrook, look, we talked about this yesterday. Always starts off slow. He's a ball-dominant guard. Now he has to share that responsibility with LeBron. That's going to take time for this team to find.
Yeah. Westbrook's good. Everything's going to be a mess in the first half of the season. Wait till the second half. Here is LeBron James at the post-game presser on Westbrook's struggles.
No, I just think it was just the first game jitters, to be honest. I don't put too much into it. Probably was a lot just going through his mind, just being a kid from L.A. and, you know, watching the Lakers growing up. And then however many years down the road, now you're putting on a Laker uniform and you're stepping into Staples Center. And you probably had, I can only imagine how many friends and family have contacted him over the last 48 hours wondering if they could come and see his first game as a Laker. Those things, those demands and those asks and those things will quiet down as the season go on and on. So not worried about Russ at all.
I love it. I love the way LBJ protects his teammate. There's no question about it. But I don't think his first game jitters being at home. He's at home all the time. He sees those people all the time. I just think that he just had a bad game. Much like you say, Jay, as the NBA expert on this particular show, is that he starts slow. And when he starts slow, he then in the second half picks up and becomes an MVP-type candidate the second half of the season. When you look at Russell Westbrook's career, this is what now, Jay? His third team in less than 12 months?
A little more than 12 months.
So when you look at Houston, Washington, now the Lakers, that's three different teams in a little bit over 12 months. He's got to get used to playing with those guys. No matter what you say, training camp is not going to get you there. The course of the season is.
It's going to happen with this team, man. Look, age, I think they're going to be fine. Like, no need for knee-jerk reactions today. You know how it is. What's wrong with the Lakers? What's wrong with Russell Westbrook? It was the first game. Obviously, there's some stats that are glaring, right? Like, they're minus 23 in his 35 minutes. They're plus 16 in his 13 minutes while he's on the bench. But those are going to be tweaks that LeBron James and Frank Vogel are going to have to make.
But isn't that because AD and LeBron has played together? What is this, the third year now playing together? AD and LeBron. Westbrook ain't
11 new players.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
It's like, come on, man.
This is the fourth consecutive season that Russell Westbrook is playing on a new team with new teammates. It's the same thing every year. Like, you got to blame yourself after a while if you fall for this. It's not going to be pretty in the first half of this season. He will get it figured out. He always does. There's someone who doesn't have to worry about first game jitters because he won't be available to play. That's next after Key has this from Granger.
All right, that 32 points by Giannis are the second most by a reigning finals MVP in a regular season opener over the last 20 seasons. And, of course, Kobe Bryant was the other to do it. He scored 33 in the 2009 season opener, his first game after being named finals MVP for the first time in his legendary career. It is time to welcome back the man, Big Perk, NBA analyst, NBA champion, not on TikTok. We'll work on that. That's okay. Big Perk, let's talk about this Lakers-Warriors game. Warriors had it working. And coming off a disappointing season, I think it was so great to see Steph getting the guys back in it. They had a groove going. The Lakers didn't.
Well, you know what? The thing that both of these teams have in common is that they have a lot of new faces. And I always say, don't take preseason for granted, right? And when you look at the Los Angeles Lakers, they took preseason for granted. You watch them throughout the course of the preseason games. They were sitting out. They weren't trying to develop any type of chemistry with all the new faces, seeing how Russell and LeBron could play off of one another. And we saw uncharacteristic turnovers. We saw defensive breakdowns. Now, when you look at the Warriors, on the other hand, they were like a fine oil machine. I mean, you know, they were moving the ball, cutting well offensively. Defensively, they was tied on the string. And when you look at the Golden State Warriors, they actually was the best team in the preseason. That's why Steph talked about chemistry, because they started building that in preseason. And when you're trying to win a championship, you don't take preseason for granted.
Absolutely not. Yeah, you better take that preseason seriously, because it translates, of course. Mm-hmm. The Lakers, little shaky. I saw some jokes, of course, about the age on Twitter. That's not going away. Their average age is almost 31 on that team. What are you seeing from them in their first game of the season?
Well, they're just trying to figure it out. I mean, one person that we can't talk about age is LeBron James, yeah, because he looked like he was, you know, 27 out there, right? But when you look at the others, you look at Carmelo, and I was looking at Frank Vogel, and it seemed like he was searching, right? Searching for the right lineup, searching for defense. And it got to a point where he put in Avery Bradley with Rondo alongside LeBron James and Anthony Davis. And you know why? Because those guys had played together 2 years ago, and Rondo knows how to play with AD. They have a great chemistry together. So right now, if I'm a Laker fan, I would not panic. Obviously, they're going to figure things out, and it's going to take a little time. I mean, because, you know, Russell Westbrook didn't look like himself. So Frank Vogel is going to have to learn how to stagger those minutes, bring him in off the bench but sub him in when LeBron is on the bench. That way Russ could flourish with the ball in his hands.
Yeah, I knew the Lakers had a busy offseason, but I didn't realize until I saw this stat that there are only three players from last year's Lakers team on the roster right now. So you put new players together, get a new team, it's going to be a totally
late in the game. And what adjustments Golden State made that you guys weren't able to counter?
We started giving up the three ball, and we had neutralized that through three quarters. And they did a good job with their second lineup of coming in and getting the three ball going. I mean, they have 55 points off the bench, you know, and that's challenging in its own self. So that team challenged you. It's a few teams that challenge you more than any other team in the league, and they're up there with them as far as challenging your defense throughout 48 minutes.
LeBron, AD was here talking about how important it was when he first arrived here. You guys lost game one, and you were the person who really lifted him up and said, it's okay, it's just one game. How important is that to kind of communicate that with Russ and maintain that same mentality?
It's always the same. I mean, you know, it's one game. We want to learn from it. We want to get better. But we don't want to harp on it too much. You know, we will get better from it, and he will get better from it. Putting him in positions where it benefits him, that benefits our team, you know, and I think we will continue to learn that as the season goes on.
LeBron, your third season now playing with AD, so you know his what makes him tick, I guess you could say. What did you see out of him today? He told us that, hey, he wants to be dominant every time he steps onto the floor this year. What did you see from him today that made you see that that's the guy that helped us win a championship?
He's in great rhythm. Quick twitch was great. Defensively, he was great. You know, he was knocking his mid-range down. He was getting into the paint. He was doing what we've grown and what I've grown accustomed to seeing AD do throughout the course of his career, and also just obviously out of the last 3 years just being his teammate.
Bron, what needs to go better for Russ going forward? What wasn't working today? What was he not doing that you guys need him to be doing to maximize all those pieces?
No, I just think it was just the first game jitters, to be honest. I don't put too much into it. You know, just probably was a lot just going through his mind, just being a kid from L.A. and, you know, watching the Lakers growing up, and then, you know, however many years down the road, now you're putting on a Laker uniform and you're stepping into Staples Center, and you're probably at, I can only imagine how many friends and family have contacted him over the last 48 hours wondering if they can come and see his first game as a Laker. You know, so, you know, those things, those demands and those asks and those things will quiet down as the season go on and on. So, not worried about Russ at all. You know, he just need to be himself and not worry about the outcome.
On that note, LeBron, adjusting to a new team, fitting into a system, takes time, but Anthony and Frank both talked about how you guys want Russ to be Russ, be aggressive, get downhill. What's it like as a player finding that balance between your style of basketball and fitting into an existing ecosystem?
I mean, it's just, you know, challenging to go into a new system and trying to fit in, but also bring what you bring to the table at a high level to fit out as well. And, you know, if it's three guys on this team that should be worrying about not fitting in, it's probably myself, AD, and Russ. Obviously, we're going to do whatever it takes to help the team win, but for us three, we need to fit out as well. You know, that's what makes us who we are as players, and that's what's going to make us the ultimate team that we want to be. So, you know, when Russ is aggressive, not only looking for a shot, looking for his teammates, and just reading, reacting, you know, that's when this game just flows and it's going to be better for our team. And, you know, that'll take time as well. I mean, this doesn't happen like overnight. It's not instant oatmeal. You have to work the process. You have to get better with it. You have to see things that benefit only not only you throughout the course of a game, throughout the course of a season, but ultimately benefits the team. But he's a he's a veteran in his league, so I'm not too worried about it.
LeBron, you guys lost a lot of the players that you counted on for kind of on-ball defense through transactions and stuff like that. The Warriors were able to kind of get into dribble penetration, especially in the second half, and get you guys into rotation and chasing possessions. How important is it going to be for this to be, I mean, I guess it's true with every team, but particularly with this group, to be a team defense, to be kind of...
No, we've always been team defense and cover for one another. And, you know, like I said, we lost two of our, you know, guys that we counted on for on-ball defense and AC and KCP. You know, but, you know, it's always been team defense. It's always been, if something breaks down, how can we cover for them? A lot of the mistakes that we made was just mental mistakes tonight. You know, forgot to switch on a certain situation, or there wasn't a time where we should have switched, gave up a back door. And then some of them was just their offense just actually executing versus our defensive schemes. You know, there's a lot of things on the floor that the normal fan wouldn't understand. They just say, why are you giving up another three or a layup? Well, sometimes it's, you know, better offense beats great defense anytime. You know, and they did a great job of executing their offense as well. So you got to give them credit.
Hey, Bron. AD told us that after the game, the three of you guys were kind of sitting there and you were kind of like joking and keeping things light. When you see a guy down like that, like, what's the message that you want to relay in that moment?
I don't know. I mean, I told Russ to go home and watch a comedy, you know, something that could put a smile on his face. So hard on himself. I told him, don't be so hard on yourself. It's one game. Understand that you, the competitor, I feel like you don't play well or play it to our ability. So I completely understand that as well. So but I just don't want him to be so hard on himself. You know, that was the one thing that I hopefully get through him. Or to him, don't be so hard on himself. And like I said, you can go home, he's going to see three babies that he has. They might be asleep, but they would put a smile on his face. And he got a beautiful wife, family. So at the end of the day, you go home and you really like, okay, all right, it's not that bad. It's really not that bad. So, but we do look forward to, you know, getting back.